All right, here's the deal. This is one of the nicest looking MagSafe battery packs you can get. It's actually made out of aluminum on the outside and then has a glass finish on the inside. It's actually thinner than Apple's own MagSafe battery pack, RIP. And I see this posted and advertised everywhere on social media, but it's got one big problem. When it comes to wireless charging speed, it's lying to you. So this is the Momax QMag X MagSafe battery pack. It's a 5,000 milliamp hour battery. In the box, you get the battery, a USB-C cable, and that's about it. And like I said, this is one of the nicest looking MagSafe battery packs you can get. If you follow the channel for any amount of time, you know I really love MagSafe battery packs. I have a bunch of Anker ones. Of course, I still have some affinity for Apple's MagSafe battery pack, but the aluminum design and the overall thinness of this battery pack is great. Because it's made out of aluminum though, it is heavier than the Apple MagSafe battery pack. The Momax comes in at 134 grams, about 4.7 ounces, whereas Apple's MagSafe is 114 grams, around 4 ounces. So it's a little heavier, again, because of those aluminum materials, but it does look nice. There is a lot of writing on the outside though, which there's writing on the inside too, so I'm not sure why they didn't just move it all to this side. But there's one big problem. Here on the battery pack itself and on their website, Momax is advertising 15 watts of wireless charging and then power delivery 3.0. That wireless charging speed is what I have a problem with. You can see on the Momax website, it supports Qi and Qi 2 wireless charging for up to 15 watts of ultra fast wireless charging. They say it again down here, easily attaches to MagSafe and Qi 2 devices. And again, right on the battery pack, it says 15 watts of charging. Now, before I even got this in hand, I went to the trusty Wireless Power Consortium database of Qi certified devices. I'll put a link to this page down in the video description, but if you ever want to check whether a device actually has Qi 2 or regular Qi charging, you can search for the brand name here. Now, I checked both under Momax and the Momax Lab Global brands, and neither of it has this battery pack listed. This QMag Pro 3, if we go into that device, you'll see that's kind of a table desktop charging stand. You can see that it is licensed, but not Qi 2. And I went through all of these just to show you another one, but none of them are the MagSafe battery pack that I'm showing here. Really, it doesn't look like any of their devices have Qi 2 just yet. I've talked about Qi 2 a lot on this channel. I actually did a whole description about why Qi 2 is better than Qi 1, and it's based off Apple's MagSafe spec. I'll link to that video down in the description if you want to hear the long explanation. But it's clear this device, the Momax QMag X, is not Qi 2. And that's really the only way to get up to 15 watt wireless charging. So I did some tests. Now there's not a great way to actually test how fast a MagSafe battery is charging your iPhone. There's some third-party apps. They all have a bunch of warnings of how battery testing got harder with modern versions of iOS. But I did ask an expert, Quinn Nelson from Snazzy Labs, which app he would recommend, and Amperese was the one. So I'll put a link to that in the video description if you want to try it too. I tested the Momax QMag X battery pack first, and as you can see, after the test, it showed about 6 watts of wireless charging, way less than the 15 watts. Now, there's a ton of factors in battery testing, like heat, how much is the battery charged, and you really have to drain it under 80% to get an accurate view. Your iPhone charges slower once it gets over that 80% mark, so in order for these apps to really measure it, it needs to be around 50% or lower. I made sure to do that to give the Momax all the chances to show a faster charge. So to be precise, for that first test with the Momax MagSafe battery pack, no case on the iPhone, it charged at about a 6.6 watt speed, which, again, nowhere near 15 watts, really closer to just regular Qi charging. Just for reference, I did the same test with a case on the iPhone, and it went down a little bit, 6.4 watt charging speed. After I let the battery drain a little bit, I ran the same test with the only legit Qi 2 MagSafe battery pack you can get here in the US, which is the Anker Qi 2 MagGo power bank. I did an entire video on this power bank. It's really thick, hopefully thinner versions are coming soon, but as you can see on the actual battery, this is certified Qi 2. And if you look it up in the Wireless Power Consortium database, you'll see it is licensed and the specification is 2.0, that's Qi 2.0. Running the same ampere test with that Qi 2 Anker battery pack, I got about 11 watt speed charging on the iPhone. It's not the full 15 watts, again, Qi 2 is a little better at heat management, so you might not get that full 15 watts, but that's almost double the speed of the Momax QMag X. So this is clearly not 15 watt charging and definitely not Qi 2. And for those wondering, I did run the test with the Apple MagSafe battery pack, even slower speeds, 5 watt charging. But as you know, this is not really meant for speed charging. It's just to kind of keep your battery alive and slowly charge, which let's just take a moment. I know many of you love the Apple MagSafe battery pack. I see you in the comments of my videos. Apple, if you're watching, just bring it back. Just put a USB-C right here instead of Lightning. We'll all be happy. You'll sell a million of them. I'll probably buy half of those. Just USB-C, that's all we need. One of the other major benefits of Qi 2 on a MagSafe battery pack like this is less heat. Heat is the enemy of your battery health and will slow down charging. The Q.Mag MagSafe battery pack from Anker is the only one that does not get hot when charging. If you ever used any of the older style MagSafe battery packs, whether it was from Anker or Mophie, you know that these get hot. And it turns out, this Momax QMag X also gets pretty warm. I wouldn't say it gets any hotter than previous MagSafe battery packs, but you can definitely tell. It gets warm, way warmer than the Q.Mag battery pack. Now, supposedly, I have the Gen 1 QMag X, and there is a Gen 2 available. The only difference I could see is the little lights that show the charge of the battery and the button has moved to the outside, which I'll give Momax is a cool feature. You see the lights down here can show you the charge of the battery. Press the button, and they light up. I kind of prefer it on the bottom, since there's already so much writing up here. And Gen 2 also supposedly has Qi 1 and Qi 2 for up to 15 watts of ultra-fast charging. But remember, this was not in the Wireless Power Consortium database either. So this does not have Qi 2, and you're going to get the same charging experience as this one. Around 6 watts, it's going to get hot, and it's pretty slow. Now, all that being said, if you used MagSafe battery packs that are not Qi 2 or Apple's, you're probably used to the heat, and maybe you don't care. And I will say, the QMag X looks great. If you go with that first generation model, it actually comes in multiple colors and multiple sizes if you want to get double the capacity at 10,000 milliamp hours. And it is thinner than Apple's MagSafe battery pack, so it's super compact. So if you want to get one, there'll be an Amazon link down in the description, but just remember, this is just regular old MagSafe battery pack. No Qi 2, no 15 watt charging. If you want legitimate Qi 2 and you're here in the US, this is your only option right now. The Anker MagGo power bank, only the 10K version. Hopefully they make a thinner version soon. And other brands have promised and even announced Qi 2 MagSafe battery packs. Belkin has multiple announced with the Qi 2 standard. Supposedly these are going to come in multiple sizes as well. Mophie also announced Qi 2 chargers. Most of these were supposed to come out in March, and we're now here in mid to late April and we still haven't seen them. So hopefully you'll get more options soon. But as for me, my battery health is already hurting. I don't need more heat on my battery. I'm at 94% capacity on this iPhone 15 Pro Max that I got on launch day. Yes, I do have a lot of charge cycles because when I'm filming videos like this or testing batteries, I get it. I'm killing my battery anyways. But if I'm gonna charge with a wireless power bank, I'm still going with the Anker Qi 2. Has that built-in stand. If you wanna watch the full review on this battery, I'll link it above and down in the description. Does not get hot like many other, pretty much all other MagSafe battery packs, except for Apple's. And it charges noticeably faster. But if you're all about looks, and you just want the thinnest MagSafe battery pack that looks really cool, made out of aluminum and glass, I mean, the QMag X is nice. And you do get faster charging if you plug in a USB-C cable directly from the battery to your iPhone. But if you're getting one of these, it's to charge wirelessly. And if you do that, you will not be getting the 15 watt advertised charging speed here on the battery. So if you have other MagSafe battery packs that you'd like me to review here on the channel, leave comments below this video. I know several had asked about this one specifically, so hopefully that helped. And to make sure you don't miss a future video, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon, hit the like button, and I'll put that review to the Anker Qi 2 battery pack right up here. And if you want some automations on how to save your battery life, I have a bunch of shortcuts which how to go into auto low power mode and a bunch of other things. I'll put that video right up here. And before you go, I'm gonna plug my podcast one more time. I have a tech podcast with Jason Aten. It's called Primary Technology. Just search in any podcast app for Primary Technology. You'll find it there. Link's also in the description. And we just started a new community using Circle. It's completely free to join. A bunch of listeners and viewers are already there. Honestly, I've kind of loved interacting with everybody there. It's one place where we could talk about the episodes, new topics, and I'm posting some behind the scenes stuff as well. So search for Primary Technology, go listen to that. I appreciate you watching. I'll catch you next time.